In today's video, we're going to be having a look at a smart dehumidifier by Inventa. We're going to be having a look at its main feature set, and if you stick around till the end, I'll be showing you how to integrate it into Home Assistant for full local control. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. In my house, I've got a utility room with a tumble dryer and washing machine, and this room happens to be right next to the front door, so whenever these are both on, they create a lot of humidity, and when this humidity meets the front door, it creates a lot of condensation. As this is a brand new house, I really wanted to reduce that condensation as much as possible in order to avoid things like mold and watermarks on the wall, and my solution for actually doing this was to make use of a dehumidifier. And this is where the Inventa dehumidifier comes in. I should also point out here that this video isn't a full review, it's more of a quick preview for the dehumidifier and also showing how to integrate this thing into Home Assistant. Full transparency as always, I was given this unit of the dehumidifier for free, but this video isn't sponsored and I was never paid or asked to create the video by Inventa, and everything you see and hear in the video are my own personal thoughts and opinions. And with that said, let's check out this thing's features and the reasons I've incorporated this into my own home. So this thing is the EVA Ion Pro Wi-Fi 20 litre dehumidifier. It's created and manufactured by Inventa Appliances, who create a wide range of different home appliances, including things like mini fridges, wine coolers, vacuum cleaners, and more. The dehumidifier's got five main features, which include Wi-Fi, an air ionizer, a HEPA filter, a carbon filter, and low noise level. By making use of Wi-Fi, you're able to connect the dehumidifier to the Inventa app and remotely control the unit. This step will be required if you want to make use of the local control with Home Assistant. By making use of the Inventa app, which is available for both Android and iOS, you're able to connect your dehumidifier to your local Wi-Fi, and once it's connected, you're able to make use of the smart controls, which allow you to control all aspects of the dehumidifier. One cool thing about this device is it has full local control, meaning it doesn't require the cloud or any additional services in order to be able to be fully operable on your home network. And those are just some of its core features. Let's have a look at what you get in the box and some of its other features. The dehumidifier comes packaged in a thick Inventa box. On the outside of the box, you'll find all the specifications for the dehumidifier, and you'll also find that Which Buy certification logo. Inside the box, you'll find the dehumidifier unit itself, as well as all of the documentation that you'll need to set it up. You'll also find a small hose which can be added to the product to give it continuous drainage so that you never have to empty the water tank. The dehumidifier's outer casing is made out of a hard white acrylic. It's got a bit of weight to it and weighs about 14 kilograms, which kind of adds to the premium feel of it. On the front of the unit, you'll find the clear blue water drawer, and this is where the water will sit if you're not using the optional drainage hose. The removable water drawer can hold up to 3 litres of water, and the dehumidifier can process about 20 litres of water a day if you keep replacing the water in it. If you're using that optional hose, then you'll never have to empty this thing out as no water will get into it. On the left of the water drawer, you'll see this grey piece of plastic, and the purpose of this little piece of plastic is to trigger the overflow sensor. So as the water rises, this piece of plastic will touch the sensor, and when the sensor touches, it will tell the unit that the water is full and it will automatically turn off the dehumidifier to prevent any unwanted water leakage. The drawer slides out very easily, even when it's got a full tank of water. There's a little plastic handle in the center to allow you to pick it up easier, so you can easily empty the water out and then slide it back into place. On the top of the unit, you'll find all of the physical buttons, which control all of the main functionality of the dehumidifier. This includes things like turning on the ion mode, changing the fan speed, changing the mode, and turning the device on and off. There's also a small display between those buttons, and this will show the value of the humidity for the room that the device is currently in, and this value is pulled straight from the hydrometer that's built into the dehumidifier. Just in front of the control buttons, you'll find the air outlet, and this is where all the air is going to be pushed out of the dehumidifier, and you'll need to leave a clearance above this in order to avoid any issues with the dehumidifier. If we head on to the back then, you'll find that drain outlet, and this is where you'll attach that hose if you want to automatically drain the water out. There's a little rubber bung that's attached to the back, so you can keep that clipped in if you're not using it. Just below that, there's an electrical diagram to show you all of the different parts and how it's all wired together. One really cool thing about this dehumidifier is everything on it is serviceable, so if you wanted to take it apart and change bits out, then it's very simple to do. Below the electrical diagram, you'll find the power cable and two sticky out pegs. These pegs allow you to wind the cable around it when it's not in use, just to keep it tidy. The majority of the back of the unit is taken up by the removable air intake grill. So if you pop this grill off, you'll find a little slot to house both the carbon filter and also the HEPA filter. Following the manufacturer's guides, you should clear the air filter every 15 days, and you should never turn the device on with no air filter on it. Some of the nice additions to the device's design are the built-in handles. So at the top of the unit are some built-in handles that just curve under the top of the unit. Another nice feature are the four caster wheels that are on the bottom of the unit, and this simply allows you to slide the device along the floor. And this could be very handy if you were moving it from room to room and didn't want to keep picking it up, especially as it can get a bit heavy with the added water. So that's a quick look at the dehumidifier's design and some of its features. Now let's have a look at how we set it up using the Inventor app. The setup's very simple. It's a simple case of downloading the app from the App Store. And once you've got the app downloaded, you'll just need to register for a user account. And with your user account signed in, you can just click Add Device. When you do that, it should automatically detect your dehumidifier, and you can then just select that and then pass your Wi-Fi credentials to it. Once you've entered your credentials, it will then just register this device against your Inventor account. With that registered on the network, you can name the device, and then you can start making use of the app to control the device. The app gives you access to all of the dehumidifier's controls. You can turn the dehumidifier on and off, you can change its mode, you can toggle between the smart mode, the continuous mode, the drying mode, and you can also adjust the fan speed. In addition to this, you can also access the scheduler, so you can set a schedule for when you want the dehumidifier to wake up, and you can set this on a regular basis or if you just want it on a couple of days. The other thing you can do with the app is you can check for any firmware updates. So at the time of recording this, the dehumidifier is currently up to date. So that's a very quick look at the setup and a very quick look at the app and some of the app functionality. It's also worth noting here that you do need to perform that setup before you move on to the next step, which is going to be setting the device up in Home Assistant. In order to get the dehumidifier into Home Assistant, there is also one other prerequisite that you need to have, and that's you need to have Hacks set up and installed in your Home Assistant. So if you haven't got Hacks, then go get it, and if you do have it, let's carry this on. So on the left there, we're just going to head into Hacks, and then from here, we're going to choose Integrations up at the top. In Hacks, we're going to hit this blue button in the bottom right corner that says Explore and Download Repositories. Then in the search box, we're going to start typing Midia. And the one that we're interested in is this bottom one. It's the Midia Dehumidifier LAN. And what this integration is going to allow us to do is to control our dehumidifier locally with Home Assistant. So we're going to select that. And then we're going to hit download this repositories in Hacks in the bottom right corner there. And then download. We'll then see that that's pending a restart. So we'll just need to reboot Home Assistant for this to kick in. So in the bottom left there, we're going to choose configuration. Then settings. And then we're going to hit restart. Once Home Assistant comes back to life, we're going to need to add that new integration. So we're going to head into configuration again, then devices and services. Then in the bottom right corner, we're going to choose add integration. And if we start typing Midia, you should see that appear in your list there as Midia Air Appliances LAN. If when you're typing it, it doesn't appear, then more than likely it's a browser cache issue. And the simplest way to fix this is to just hit control and hit F5. So we're going to select that. And that should then just take a second to run through the setup. Once that completes, it's going to ask us to sign into our Midia app account, and this account is going to be the account that you signed into on the Inventor app. So go ahead and enter those account details, the username and password there. With those entered, you can go ahead and click submit. And then you might see something like this where it says it's been unable to discover your appliance with the name of the dehumidifier. So in my case, mine is just called dehumidifier. And what we can do here is select the IPv4 address of the device. So go look that up in your router and then paste the IP address in here. And once you've pasted that address in, you want to just scroll down and hit submit. What this will then do is it will go and get those API tokens for that device, and this device will then be controllable locally. So I can see that mine's found it there and it's been added in as dehumidifier. And if I hit finish there, I can now see that device has been added into Home Assistant. So if we have a quick look here, we can see that we've got one device and four entities. So if we select that device, we can see that that singular device is my dehumidifier. And I can see I've got a couple of different controls here that are exposed. So I've got the dehumidifier on or off, I've got the fan controls, and I've also got that ion mode. I can then also see here for the sensors, I've got a humidity sensor, I've got an option for if the tank is full, and I've also got the current temperature of the dehumidifier. By selecting the dehumidifier at the top, we can head into the controls, and we can switch between those three different modes that are offered by this particular model. So we can have the drying mode, the continuous mode, and also that smart mode. All of the dehumidifier's controls and sensors are all available from within your scripts and automations, and in a future video I'll be showing you how I've automated this dehumidifier so that it reacts to my tumble dryer or washing machine being used. Before we wrap this up then, let's quickly run through some pros and cons for this device. So let's start off with the pros, and our first pro is obviously local control. So from a smart home and a home assistant perspective, local control is ideally what we want. We don't rely on any cloud services or need any additional services or subscriptions to actually be able to control a device that we have. Next up, we've got the casters. Now, this might seem like a very small thing, but having those wheels on the bottom just makes it so much easier to move this thing around. And if you're not mounting it on a tabletop or a surface, then these casters are going to be ideal for when you want to just move it from one room to another. And the final pro then is definitely going to have to be the drainage. Now, a lot of dehumidifiers in this category don't actually offer this, so it's nice that this one does. And on the topic of the hose, let's move over to the cons, because I've also got the hose listed as a con. This is based on me and my setup, but I'd personally like it if the hose was at least double, if not triple in length, and that would just give you a bit more flexibility in order to actually lay it down a drain or pipe it out of a window or something. And my second con is also to do with length, so I'd like it if the power cable was also a little bit longer, and that would just give you a bit more flexibility and freedom with when you're placing and laying this device. Another con that I have is again down to personal preference, and it's the fact that the water tank doesn't have a convenient pouring method. So there's just a square cutout that you can pour the water out of, and I found that if you don't do this properly, it can spill everywhere. And my final con then is to do with one of the dehumidifier's main features, which is the low noise levels. Although on lower fan speeds and lower energy modes, the dehumidifier is a lot quieter, I'd never list this as a low noise level, as it does make a fair bit of noise. Now, it's not going to be anything earth-breaking, and it's not really going to keep you up at night. At least it doesn't bother me anyway, but I wouldn't list this as a feature, so that's why I'm calling it a con. Overall, I think this is a great smart home dehumidifier, and I would highly recommend it. If you are interested in seeing a full review of this thing and some of the automations that I've set up and I'm making use of, then do make sure you are subscribed. And there we go, guys. That's been a quick look at the EVA Ion Pro Wi-Fi Dehumidifier by Inventor. If you've enjoyed this video, then don't forget to drop me a like, and if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. As always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons. If you're interested in helping support my channel, which in turn allows me to create content like this, then you'll find a link to my Patreon in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.